Hi, I'm Don Nicholas, and this is Street Vibes. Today, the people answer the question, how have you been managing since COVID struck St. Lucia?
Well, I've been coping one day at a time. That's how I've been coping, you know. Things are kind of very rare right now, very rare. Everybody's living on because it's time stops, so everybody just, they're living on, waiting to see what's next, you know, but time, it has been very rough for everybody. You know, who eating, but some who's not eating, suffering. You understand, it's very hard. So right now we have to work together and help a neighbor, help a friend, you know, because it's, the economy is out.
It's just a little bit difficult in everyday living. So I think I just take it one day at a time and go together with the flow, you know, yeah. But it's hard, it's very difficult.
I guess for now I can say okay.
Why? Yeah, why?
I'm alive.
Okay, what have you been doing since COVID? How have you been, have you, yourself, if you have your children, how have you been managing?
We've been managing okay. Yeah. Oh, no, no. My children are grown and at their home, so. But it's okay. Right. I have no question. But I have one question I would like the president of the teachers' union to answer for me. If he wants schools to close, than the children to stay home and do their work, tell him to knock on every door and find out if the children have the necessary things in place to do that.
Well, basically, my occupation more or less was entertainment, which I did at the hotel, and when everything is basically closed. But also, I also do some leather craft. So it's off that, and I also operate a small shop on the system of Boston, so just been taking it as it comes.
There's nothing to really complain about. COVID hasn't affected me in any way. Even before there was COVID, I was living my life normal. So take precautions, wash your hands. That's as far as you can do. What else can you do? Wear your mask if you figure to wear it, but do not put laws on people where I'm walking in, like, oh, I could barely breathe. I came from the bus, I'm rushing to go to the bank. I could barely, don't. My last incident there was, they want me to put a mask on my face because I'm walking. Right, you understand? And I, when it comes to walking, I cannot breathe properly. So it hasn't affected me in any way. Even before COVID, I was suffering. So COVID doesn't make a difference. It doesn't.
To be quite honest with you, as a freelancer, it has been horrible. Horrible, horrible, horrible. And what makes it even sadder, that there are people who are worse off than I am. And I try my best to help as much others as much as I can, given my limited my own limited resources, but it has not been good. For many of us like me, many people like me, we have had no form of follow-up, no form of support, no form of stimulus, nothing. And I'm not being anti-government or anything like that, I'm just saying what it is. Because if you look around, whereas you have, may have vendors, you may have this, there are a lot of us who are not vendors. We work in the creative arts, we work in other sectors, and all these sectors have been closed. And there's nothing happening in the country to help stimulate those sectors. I mean, if the government did something to help the local economy, that would have been better than to help the foreign economy.
Oh boy, I'll say very frustrating. Yeah, the people, the majority of the passengers and the people, they don't listen. There's one thing I can say now, for sure. My passengers, they're coping. They're doing well enough. But it's a sore eye to see you walking out in town and people have the mask under their throats, below their noses. It's frustrating. Yeah. And if I had enough money right now, I would stay home until next year. I would pack my phone. There's a risk coming out on the road. People don't listen, they don't hear. Yeah, it's scary.
Well, this has been Street Vibes with me, Don Nicholas. We now take you back to our studio.